nonlinear, faster, the energy absorption. That is method of solving is mathematically complete, but getting an exact solution is almost impossible. But except very few simple tests, you make many of the assumptions. Number of assumptions you use to the derived or formulated equations. In some cases, in very few cases, you have the exact solutions. That is called the analytical solution. So analytical solution may be better. It can, because it will be in the form of a closed form, in the form of equations. So whatever the point you can just substitute in that equation, you will get the different parameters. So analytical solution will be the best equation, so that it gives the complete information at all the points. So that is not always available except for a simple cases. In such cases, the only research opportunity left is you have to get at least an approximate solution. So what we are, the best should be the exact solution which will be applicable to all the points. That is the analytical solution, but it is not possible in all the cases. So as we engineers, we have to create something. Our objective is to creation. So during that, without solution, somehow we have to get solution, and we have to be satisfied at least if we get a reasonably accurate, or approximate solutions which will be serving our purpose. So getting a reasonably approximate numerical solution is called computational methods. So which will not be there at all points as exact solutions, at some predefined points, or maybe grid points or nodes, we will get some values using that with the help of computer, because we have to be lot number of numerical computation, sorry, computation method. So the computation method also, first there should be a theoretical model or mathematical model. That mathematical model will be, because all the mathematical models, as I said, they will be of differential equation. So solving a differential equation is always very difficult. But there are another set of equations called algebraic equations. So algebraic equation is relatively easy to solve. So in this computational method, whatever may be the main step is first, the differential equations will be converted into algebraic equations. So there will be different approaches in converting these differential equations into algebraic equation. But that differential term has to be converted into a difference scheme, maybe like infinite difference method. So one of the method in the conversion is finite difference method, in which the differential terms in the differential equation will be converted to difference. Difference is the algebra. So differential to algebraic equation. So one method is finite difference. Also another is finite element method. So in the finite element method also is a procedure for converting the algebraic problem. So you will not be knowing what the result, but he may expecting something, but he may be getting a result which is totally out of what he was expecting. So that systematically aiming for a solution of an unknown problem is the truth. So as in UG, sorry, as a PG, you should have some component of research in your studies also, because you either after this, you may go for other studies for PhD or maybe for teaching or even if you are going to the industries, you will be mostly employed in the research and development or in the design or analysis department.